Do you still sit here and say you have never been with underage girls? Can you really say that?
I sit here and say this. I had two cases back then that I said in the beginning of the interview that I would not talk about because of my ongoing case now.
Okay,
fair enough. But
okay.
I will tell you this. People are going back to my past, okay? That's exactly what they're doing. They're going back to the past, and they're trying to add all of this stuff now to that, to make all of the stuff that's going on now feels real to people.
But the past is relevant with you with underage girls.
Absolutely, no, it's not.
Why?
Because, for one, I beat my case. When you beat something, you beat it.
You were acquitted.
We can't double jeopardy me like that. You can't. It's not fair. It's not fair to nobody. When you beat your case, you beat your case.
But I'm not talking about the one case in which you were acquitted. I'm talking about the other cases where women have come.
Have y'all seen this clip floating around of R. Kelly's interview this morning with Gayle King on CBS this morning? I don't know who R. Kelly's handlers are, his manager, his PR team. I don't know. Maybe he doesn't even have that much, those many people hanging around him anymore because, you know, the money has stopped. But I am curious as to who thought it was a good idea to have him go on national TV and interview with Gayle King or plead his case, so to speak. I cringed throughout that whole clip. I just did. And I'm sure there's more to come. They're only putting this part out to kind of get us, you know, just kind of caught into it, ready to watch it. I'm sure CBS probably ain't going to never have as many ratings as they have this morning on their show. Because usually I watch Good Morning America. Okay. But just watching that clip, I'm just cringing at that. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I think it wasn't a good idea to do this interview. I just don't. Now, this is a man who, as he said, is fighting for his life. So he's emotional. Now, a lot of people will see his tears. They are saying, you know, he's a master manipulator. He's a narcissist. Those tears don't mean a goddamn thing. And then there are people, of course, the people that believe him and are in his corner are feeling bad for him. You know, I'm not going to say either way, okay? Because I've already said my opinion about R. Kelly, and it's I'm not here to give my opinion on that, whether he's manipulative or not. But Geronda Pace, who was with R. Kelly at one time, remember, she's the young girl that used to be at the courthouse. She put something up when she watched it. She said, "Studying psychology has done great things for me. Looking at that clip of Robert during his interview for Gayle King, I didn't see R. Kelly. I didn't see my abuser. I didn't want to read him with a biased attitude. What I saw was a man that needs help. For decades, he's been around enablers who've never told him the truth. When you've been doing wrong for decades and the people around you make you feel that your actions are right, you tend to believe that you're doing no wrong. Him believing he's doing no wrong is no different than an adult telling a child Santa is real. That child grows up thinking that Santa is real because that's what they've been hearing since baby days. I don't believe that prison will help or fix Robert's actual problems. Truth is, he's fighting for his beliefs. In his heart, mind, body, and soul, he believes he's done no wrong. I think asylum is what he needs. 24/7 care and attention. A psych evaluation is mandatory. Mental health is important." So that is from Geronda Pace. She would know. She was with him. A lot of people are giving her heat for coming out and saying that. Some people are saying, you know, make up your mind, but she's showing some compassion. So again, I don't know if he should have did this interview, but you guys let me know what you think after you watch it. Let me know what you're thinking here, and I'll talk to you guys later.